I immediately got a game. It's a 10 plus 10 game. Here's the opponent's nick and his rating. Oh, 2 bishop c4. Yeah, I will go knight f6. Aha. And he plays this gambit. Yeah, what to do? I think e takes d4 is the right move. And if he goes knight f3, I will go bishop b4 check, I believe. C3, yes. How did it go? I don't remember this. Was it d takes? Or was it... I think it was d takes c3. And if knight c3, if he plays knight c3, I think I am supposed to play d5. He can also castle. Now, then I take on b2. He plays bishop takes. And then, aha, okay, so he does this. I think. Yeah, I mean, or do I play d5? This is the question. Do I go d5? He takes on b4. I take on c4. If he d5, bishop b5, c6. He takes there. I take there. I think I am supposed to play d5. If queen a4, I believe I will just play bishop d7. Okay. So let's drop back to d6 now. maybe I should have queen e7, bishop e3, bishop c5, castles, takes e3, he has rook e1. Yeah, so queen e7 wouldn't have net me anything. So if he plays queen e2 now. Queen e2, I think he does it. I think queen e7 is not nice. Or maybe I just play king takes e7. If I play bishop e7, castles, castles. Yeah. Let me play queen e7, and if he takes, I will take with the king. Yeah, I didn't want bishop e7 because of bishop f4. Yeah, he can do this, of course. Maybe bishop b5. Maybe bishop b5. Yeah, using this X pin, the X ray. Okay, he doesn't do it. Yeah, I guess I have to go back to. Okay. Yeah, so let me take. How do I take? Is knight takes an option? I don't think so. So let me take with the king. Let me drop back. Yeah, I mean, this is obviously not the way how black should handle this gambit. All the pieces are not developed yet. But the question is, how can white take an advantage of this? Okay, he wants f5. Fair enough. Knight f5 is his idea. Or knight b5, which may also be a possibility. H6 takes, takes, knight b5. Like knight b6 is also possible. Then bishop f6, I take on c4. He has bishop g7. Knight b6, takes f6, takes f6. The bishop moves. Knight e5. okay, let's play it simple and ask him what to do with his bishop. I mean, if he plays knight b5, let's say he takes on f6, knight b5. At least I can, I can just ignore it, and let him take on d6. I think nothing really bad is happening to me then. Yeah, knight b5 now probably. he has a potentially bad bishop. So and knight b5 and taking on d6 isn't a real threat, in my opinion. So knight b5, bishop d7. He has maybe rook b1. Aha. And he does something entirely different. Okay. Yeah, so let's play bishop d7. Rook b1 played. Okay, what is his idea? I'm not seeing it yet. So, technically, I could play c5. But it doesn't look that convincing to me. Okay, let's play rook e8. Aha, king f1. Okay. Knight e4, he can take, rook e1. Don't know what. Okay, let's play Bishop C5. If possible, let's say if he goes Rook E1. Yeah, we can exchange. Okay. Let's play knight e4 now. He cannot play c4 because I take on d4, take d4, and knight d2 check. How can I further improve my position? Okay, let's say he plays Rook C1. Rook C1, what can I do? Rook C1. He goes for it. So he is in passive defense right now. So let me take some space. Is G5 a move? Or is this now a move? Okay, let's go for it. Yeah, those squares, yeah, with the king on d6. Here are the knight checks. Yeah, both are covered due to my bishop. And if needed, I can still go a6 or g6. Yeah, and I just want to activate my king to have a look at his, knight e5 is now possible. Oh, knight e5. Aha, he goes c4. Okay, so let's go king d6. If he plays, I can take. And take on f2. Yeah, so knight b5 is not possible. So what are my ideas? Take on d4, takes, knight check, king moves. I can take on knight b5, yeah, but why does this work? Can't I just take this now? Where is his compensation? I don't get it. I mean, bishop c2, I just remove the bishop. And if he pins me, I can play knight f6. Yeah, I think he just lost the pawn. And yeah, his bishop remains quite passive. Yeah, A4 played. Yeah, so let me just drop back. So knight c5, bishop c2. Can I then even take on d5 a pawn? And rook played. Okay. Yeah, let me just drop back. Yeah, I think this pawn is a goner. If we exchange rooks, he takes, okay. So he wants to give a check on e4 or on c4. Ah, wait. Wait. Knight f6, knight c4, king here. There is knight e5. Knight e5. Yeah, but it shouldn't be. Uh, I don't think this is a problem. Yeah, let's take this pawn. I mean, he can take here. As long as I... As long as I get those pawns, I'm completely... Aha, knight d8 is also in the position. Knight d8. Ah, come on, but it has to work. I mean, I'm getting after knight d8, can I go c6? C6. He takes on b6, takes d8. Yeah, this should... And c6, he takes on b7 with check. Okay. Yeah, so then I have to do this. His king remains passive. He is still in the box. This I can just take. Okay, so let's have a look with the engine. The opening was, it is not, you don't the resulting position was not nice. I think this is still okay, I believe. Yeah, and here it felt... It began to feel wrong, in my opinion. Okay, so knight d4 was not great. I played h6. Yeah, and if he would have gone here, or engine says, okay. I can even play this one, to get a tempo, and then I can kick the knight back. Yeah, this I did not see. During the game, I thought, let's say I play bishop d7, he takes, and it's similar to what happened in the game. I mean, he has the more, his structure is weaker than mine. Yeah, here my pawns are on dark squares. I do have a lovely square for my knight on c5. I think black is better here as well. Rook e8, king f1. Aha. Engine says I can even take. Yeah, of course, because here this is mate. Nice. Oh, hey. Hey, I didn't see your comment in the chat before. How are you? I wish you a happy new year, of course. So, bishop h2 is possible. And if he cannot play g3, I can just return afterwards, yeah, of course. So I played bishop c5, knight here, knight e4, rook c1, and now, yeah, I wanted to play g5, yeah, to get, well, did I, or was it with my king already on d6? Yeah, but getting more space is of course always important feature in endgames. Yeah, and here those knights, they are called superfluous knights. Yeah, they are standing on each other's toes. And yeah, maybe with g4 I can how can I say this in English? Yeah, I can break the structure of the knights. Yeah. So I played this, which is still okay. C4, king d6. Yeah, and this is already hard to believe for me. Yeah, this is almost minus two according to the engine. I mean, that black is better, there's no doubt. But minus two? This is a... Wow. Okay, let me make... Let's say I play h3. a5. Let me play h4. G5. Okay, take, take. Let's say I go king g1. Ah, yeah, of course, and then already the piece is gone, yeah. Yeah, and if a knight moves, yeah, then f2 is again falling, yeah. Okay, so he played knight b5. I took a4, I just went back. Engine likes f5, which makes a lot of sense as well, I guess. Yeah, I played it simple. Aha. Oh, there was a5 in the position. Oops, we blundered both. Takes, takes. Oh, okay, I get the piece back. Yeah, and this is, of course, yeah, and then. Okay, I remain a pawn up, but yeah, it's of course very still very difficult. So he went knight e5, king b4 is okay, this is fine as well. Knight here, king b4, yeah, and then he blundered. If he plays this. Oh, engine even likes c5. Takes. Aha. Yeah, cutting off the knight. Yeah, so you have to do this. Take 96, bishop c7. And then I guess you just protect the pawn and pick up this one. Yeah, okay. So, what's the time? Okay. I can play one more game. I can play one more game. Let's take a blitz game. Because the Chess 24 tournament is starting soon.